can we, as a society, reduce our carbon emissions to the point that we need to? As an engineer, my answer is yes, of course, we can. I am solidly convinced we have the technology, we have the ability. Do we have the social will to? That's a really difficult question.
We're here today with Ted Borer, Energy Plant Director at Princeton University, to talk about the university's new goals to reduce greenhouse gas emissions on campus.
The first goal we set as an institution was to reduce our greenhouse gas emissions to 1990 levels by year 2020. Our next milestone is to reduce these emissions further to about 25% below 1990 levels. This sounds like it should be easy, but the campus has grown significantly over time. That means more square footage, more air conditioning, more overall energy loads that we need to account for. The university has a longer-term goal that is much more ambitious, and that is to get our total carbon footprint down to net zero by year 2046. To get there, we have to start today with early action. Just like at your house, first you want to reduce use, and then you want to deliver energy as efficiently as possible, and then you want to make that energy with renewable sources. We're going to do the same thing on a campus scale here. One of the things that's very important is to have energy storage. What we're doing on campus right now is we're drilling a series of wells. We're building a Geo Exchange system where we take heat from the buildings and instead of rejecting it through a cooling tower to cool off the campus, we'll reject it to the rock underneath the campus. The water will be cooled off by the rock in the ground. The rock eventually will get warmer and warmer all summer. Then I've got thousands and tens of thousands of cubic yards of warmer rock as a resource that we can use for heating the campus all winter. What is amazing from my seat right now is seeing that the university can fully do this. We have the ability to get our carbon footprint down to zero. We actually know how to do this, and we have the technology. It's not that we need to invent anything new. It exists today. And I am very excited. Essentially, what we need is permission, because even the economics work in our favor. When we do a life cycle cost analysis, we find that it's actually less expensive to build and operate and maintain the new systems than it is to continue maintaining and operating the existing systems. Princeton has the almost unique opportunity to lead by example. So even in the actions of our facilities, other people are going to look at us and say, wow, now that I see that Princeton has done that, I get it. I don't need to take exactly the same steps that Princeton did, but I can follow Princeton's thought process and I can make steps forward and I can reduce my own carbon footprint as well. We can influence thousands, tens of thousands, even millions of others by example.